In this video, we're going to be showing you how to build a Delaque Ganger. The build we're going to be going on is Cave, which is pose number 2. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is get some tools together. And as you can see here, I've got some clippers, a mold line remover, some plastic glue, and of course, the frame that we're going to be clipping Cave from. Now, the other thing I recommend doing is having a read over the instruction guide just to familiarise yourself with which parts go where. So the first thing we're going to clip out is going to be his head, his neck, and his body. So this is going to be parts 23, which you can just see here. We've got parts 22, which is the neck joint, and then we've got parts number 4, which is his head. So we're going to start clipping these out. Now, I always recommend using the flat side of the clippers against the part you need to clip out. We'll give it a nice flush cut. So once we've clipped all these parts out, we're going to then clean them up using a mold line remover. With the parts now clipped out, we're going to start cleaning them with a mold line remover. Now, a mold line tends to be a line, a very faint line that runs down the middle of the model. This is part of the molding process, and all we need to do is just firmly just rub the mold line remover, and this will remove it. It might leave some discoloration, but don't worry about that, because once you start painting, you won't see it. And you want to do this on all the parts you clip out. With all those parts now cleaned with a mold line remover, we're going to move on to the next part, which is start doing some gluing. Now, the first thing we're going to do is glue the head to the neck. It's always worth dry fitting these just beforehand, just to make sure you're happy with where they go together. But what we're going to do here is we're just going to attach a little bit of glue to this neck bit here. Now, it's only a little bit we need, don't need too much. And we're just going to attach the head. Now, it should fit nice and snugly because this is designed for this head in particular, like so. And then we'll need to leave that for about 5 minutes just to dry. And there we are with the head and neck now glued together. We're going to go on to the next part, which is now to glue that to the front part of the torso. So if I just grab the front part of the torso, you can see just here, we need to just apply a little bit of glue. It's almost like a little shelf, if you like. It's just at the very front where his rebreather is. So just add a little dollop of glue in there. I'm going to grab the head. And all we need to do is just slide it in. So it's just a nice little subtle slide like so. That'll fit nice and firmly in like there. With those components now dry, we're going to move on to clipping out the next bit, which is parts 24. So this is the back part of the body. So it's just the part here. So what I'm going to do is just clip this out. We're going to clean it with the mold line remover, and then we'll glue it to the back of the body. And there we are, with that piece now glued on, we're going to move on to the next bit, which is part 25. Now you'll find part 25 just here on the sprue. We're going to clip this out. This is the back part of his cloak, or overcoat if you like. We'll clip that all out, we'll then clean it and then glue it. And there we are, with the main part of the body now assembled, we're going to move on to the next part, which is do a couple of sub-assemblies, and this is going to be the weapon arm. So first of all, we're going to clip out part 28, which is his right arm, and part 29, which is his right pistol hand. We're now going to clip these parts out, we're going to clean them up, we're going to glue them together as a small sub-assembly, then we'll attach them to the main body. And there we are, with the weapon arm sub-assembly now glued together, we're going to move on to the next part, which is to now glue it to the rest of his body. So all we're going to do is apply a little bit of plastic glue just to his arm. There's a nice flat area there for you to use. And then I'm just going to grab the arm and attach it like so. Now, a key thing here is to try and get it nice and vertical. So all we need to do is just apply it like that. If it does start to move down, you can just, because it's plastic glue, you've got a little bit of movement, so you can just adjust that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to clip out the other parts to build the left arm. We'll get that glued together and attach the model as well. And there we are with that left arm sub-assembly now glued. We're going to move on to the final parts, which is to clip out his daggers and also his rebreather canister. So you'll find these on the sprue. So the daggers are part 68, so we're just going to clip those out. And the rebreather canister is just up here, which is part 30. So clip them out and give them a nice clean. We'll also glue the daggers on. There we are with the knives now glued on. The last thing to glue on is his rebreather canister and hose. Now this is a little bit fiddly, so it will require some dry fitting before you glue it. Now you do have some little areas on his belt where you can connect it, but like I said, it's a bit fiddly, so do test fit it before you actually glue it. Once you're happy, then glue it on. And there we are with his rebreather now attached. The final thing to do is glue him to his base. So what I'm going to do is apply a little bit of plastic glue just the base of his feet like so, just a little dollop here and there. And then I'm going to grab him and put him onto his base. I'm going to try and make sure he's nice and central, so I'm just going to give him a quick twizzle like so. Make sure it's nice and firmly on. And there we are. He's now ready to be painted. And there we are. Cave the Delaque Ganger is now built. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy building your own Delaque Gangers, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.